Theme parks never stand still. That's why we are now going into a news recap for the week 9, 2021. Hey guys, just a quick note. I've launched a Discord server for us. There's just a general channel at the moment, but some specific sub-channels may follow over time to discuss whatever you like to. Link is in the description, feel free to join. Six Flags refreshes a classic. At Six Flags Over Georgia, this winter, the Schwarzkopf Looping Coaster Mindbender will undergo an extensive refurbishment. As Screamscape reports, there will be major improvements, including reworking some parts of the track, and the classic coaster will also get new trains. From which company the new trains will be delivered is not yet finally confirmed, but we might assume that Gerstlauer could be in the game here. The German manufacturer had already developed new trains for the revolution at Six Flags Magic Mountain, so the most important plans for the construction of new carriages would already be in the drawer. In addition, the coaster is apparently getting a change of theme and name. When it reopens, the full name will be the Riddler Mindbender. Whether there will be bigger themed elements or just an adapted logo remains to be seen, as well as known by Six Flags. Nevertheless, I am happy that they continue to pay attention to the classic and apparently don't think about tearing it down for a while longer. After all, the Schwarzkopf rides are becoming quite rare. Music and trains for a movie park coaster. That the Movie Park Germany is working on one of the most interesting German novelties for 2021 should be no secret by now. In the meantime, the soundtrack producer Imascore has officially confirmed on Facebook that they will provide the music score for the Dark Ride roller coaster. Currently, they are working with a 63-musician orchestra supported by a 40-member choir on the soundtrack to the movie-like roller coaster ride. Speaking of roller coaster rides, something has to go on the rails. There's also good news because the first trains have arrived at Movie Park, as reported on their own Facebook presence. Of course, the park does not miss the opportunity to give us some detailed pictures of the vehicles to enjoy. Even if the individual cars were kept very clean, they still came up with some nice details in the paintwork. The cars apparently resemble tram tour cars, of course, including a license plate. I think this is more than sufficient since the roller coaster is most of the time indoors anyway. Epic Universe work resumes. In the wake of the corona pandemic, work on Universal's Epic Universe park was completely halted for the time being in July 2020. Now the company has reported in a press release that work will resume immediately. The project will be resumed immediately at high to full capacity. Universal once again clearly emphasized that this project will be essential for the economy in and around Orlando and Florida. Hundreds of jobs will be created within Universal and thousands will be strengthened outside the parks and the company. When completed, the new park is expected to provide approximately 14,000 jobs across the resort. The project includes not only Universal's third theme park in Florida, but also additional hotels, entertainment centers and stores, as well as restaurants on 750 acres. This is roughly equivalent to 3 square kilometers of land, nearly double the area of the existing Universal Resort in Orlando. That's it for the news recap for the week 9, 2021. If there's enough news, I will bring you a new recap next Sunday. If you want to stay up to date, leave me a like, a sub or a comment, or follow me on my other social media channels.